It is the cave. Welcome back, by the way, to Chaos. It is about a half day's march away from the city. Like, you go outside of the gate.
Into the dark.
You go to the Underdark.
Of Under.
You don't really encounter anything because they have scouting parties that
clear out.
Keep most of this area clear.
We are the scouting party to take out the beholder, though.
Yes. Cave.
Because they don't want to send their mechs to be messed with this.
Alright, let's get
physical. Physical.
I can't help but think about Randy Couture singing that song. You ever lip sync battle?
No.
It's this TV show where celebrities go on and lip sync to songs. Yeah. There's an episode, Randy Couture versus Gabriel Iglesias.
Oh my gosh.
He lip sync with a in costume dance number to Let's Get Physical.
That's fucking magical, is what that is.
Kind of was. The only problem was he was going up against Gabriel Iglesias. And Fluffy dressed up like Beyonce.
Oh my.
And had Beyonce come out and dance with him.
Wow.
That's no, didn't. Never mind. That was Channing Tatum.
Okay.
Yes.
That's even less fair.
Fluffy wore a dress and.
I think he sang Janet Jackson.
Fell down.
Yeah, I think he sang Janet Jackson.
I need yo's for you guys. Na.
What kind of yo's are you looking for?
Us?
This will be Kyle.
Oh. Us.
Yes, us.
USA. USA.
He picked one of the drow wizards. They're in there for me.
Okay.
Or the fiery sorcerer guy.
This will be Herc. This will be Elias. And of course.
There's no rules about that.
That's the only rule about that.
There's no rules! There's one rule.
Okay. So we get into the place.
I'm guessing we're stepping like over the dead bodies right now.
Careful.
You're stepping around.
And the petrified one, and the crispy one, and the shadow of one.
Is there anything of interest on the dead bodies that we could take?
The dead bodies that are intact enough that would have anything of value are petrified, so they're entirely stone. So probably not, unless you have a greater restoration spell.
No.
Which I don't.
Yeah, we don't have a cleric or a druid.
Does.
No, we're good.
So. Give me, as you enter the cave here, let's do some more part. Let's do some perception checks.
19.
I'm so good at perception. 11.
21.
Nice.
19.
Oh,
really?
19.
8. 15. 14. I am the monster of the cave.
There's a giant tiger.
A giant gray beast.
The little ones.
Stands upon the land.
I don't have but the one, so we're just gonna deal with that.
You can put dice and say they're the same thing.
Yes, I can.
Yeah.
Your little
where's the
Pileo dice bag.
The what?
Oh. I could use this. I got it. That's fair.
How many of these do I want?
Throw you guys.
That's
Oops.
Too many.
Two. Yes.
Fuck.
This is too many, for sure.
No, that's funny. Stop anytime. Ah, you've gone too far.
Blasphemy.
How dare you?
It's two.
You
have Scallion. Three, four. That'll be fine. There's six total. 21. 19, Soren. You see that there are these little, say little, and they're medium size. They're about the size of you guys.
You mean you guys?
I mean exactly what I mean.
Beholder looking things with like only four stalks.
Yes, they have four tentacles. You are, for the most part, stealth.
Fuck's sake.
For the most part.
Herc is very much so not. So, where's Herc? Herc is here. You all, are you letting Herc go up front? Or are
of course.
You stealthing
we can't
in?
Stop him.
Not physically.
That's fair. So you kind of rush up. You kind of rush
I'm
in.
Not straight. I can physically stop you.
Being all noisy.
Mm-hmm. One of the reasons why we can stealth so well.
Sure,
we're jumping right in to this. Up to two of the following rays. Alright, need some D4 action. It's going to target you. They, I guess, are going to target you.
Wait, surprise round?
Yeah.
He can't be surprised.
So I get to roll normal initiative.
Yeah, he gets roll initiative against theirs because he doesn't get surprised.
Oh, yeah.
And I can't be surprised either.
So those two get...
Well, you're not in any kind of blast
so.
Range.
It's
so.
True, too. I'm just saying, I can't be surprised.
Roll your initiative, which you have advantage on.
I do not have advantage on the surprise.
Oh.
Just the regular.
Just the regular.
Okay, so what's
okay.
your total?
He still rolled a 21.
Yeah.
That's going to beat me.
So you still get to go first. Fuck yeah.
Hang on.
So you basically walked around the corner and went, ha!
21?
Yeah, 21.
Yeah, everyone else go ahead and roll. Herc. Leos.
8.
Never mind, I'll fill that.
20.
20.
I like being alert. It gives me a +5 to my initiative. So where's my
really
initiative
bad.
Supposed to be right now?
Hmm?
Where's that
actually?
Yeah, where do you find your initiative
levels at? It's dex modifier.
Unless okay. you have other kinds
an
of...
An alert would add 5 to your dex modifier.
Yeah, so it's 7. Oh. That's why I'm plus
Sorry.
7.
10. Probably should have changed it a while back.
Okay. It's not going to make a massive difference.
No.
Which is fine. Down. Okay, Herc, you got a little bit of activity here that you can do before they go.
You have a little
as their surprise roundy rounds at 40.
Smashy, smashy, punchy, deathy.
Yep. First, run up to this one. And he screams testicular torsion. As he swings the ice flail, smashes the flail of impact, and comes back around the ice.
Are you using one of your charges? Or
only
are you saving
flail,
that?
Only on the flail of impact.
Well, right, right, but
yes,
you're going ahead with that? You realize you have the boss coming up.
Yeah, but sacrifice one.
There you go.
Sacrifice one just to thin the herd real
it's cool.
quick.
He's cool. He's cool.
Oh, at least 6 feet. It looks bad.
I mean, it's fine. You do...
I'd rather have 5 than 6, so...
Do it. Do it. So you get 3 attacks.
I'll do it.
Are you raging?
He can't rage yet.
Yeah, he can, as
attack.
A bonus action.
Does he?
Yeah, as a bonus action, you can rage right at the beginning.
Oh.
Okay.
Before you attack.
You just lose the rage if you are, like...
Not attacking or not taking
damage.
If there's
a round where you're not attacking or you don't take damage.
Yeah.
Okay.
But that shouldn't happen, so...
Yeah, don't worry about this.
So, go ahead and rage.
Shouldn't we
all 3 months? Ah, there we go. That's what that was for. So I got
15,
22,
and
27.
Jesus.
Those are all hits.
All hits. All right.
You're hitting number one.
Plus
a d6.
I got
that.
First one for ice.
Plus 6.
Wait.
Plus zero
roll.
Strength.
Wait, yeah, it's supposed to roll a d8.
It's a
d8
plus a
d6,
yeah.
Yeah. Oops. 7.
7 plus your strength is 12, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And then it was 3. D6 when I use the impact thingy?
Yes.
Okay. Plus a D8.
Wait. Which one do you want for the splash damage? I guess you can roll that separate. That's fine.
The yellow and splash.
Okay.
Splash 3.
Ooh.
And, yeah. 6, 6, 2.
14, and then the 3 splash damage.
Well, no. It's 14 plus the 3, and then, the 3 will surpass and go splash damage.
Plus the strength, right?
Plus strength, yeah.
So 19 before the splash damage, plus the 3 gives you
22?
Plus splash
3. I'm guessing 10 feet.
5 feet.
Oh, so 5 feet from where he's standing. Yeah.
You will take... splash.
And then the last one is just another d6.
Of course, three times per short rest means that you would only take at most 18 damage from your own attack, so it's like nothing.
Yeah.
Of his 176.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I figured. I figured you wouldn't have a problem with that at all.
The backlash, the torsion is 6 and 13, 18. All them damages.
How do you want to do this?
Fucking
scream, let's take some torsion and just
smash its face through.
Destroy, dear God, what has Hurt been through these days is what they're all thinking, because that was just fucking brutal.
Okay.
Shit. How much damage did you do that round?
52.
So not a lot of damage to
these
smaller guys.
Yeah. Alright, it's your turn now. They just saw
him. One die the fucking
one
death.
Get
the death. Not just any death. The death.
You're gonna get some rays aimed at you. Perk.
Go figures.
What is the range of these rays? 98 feet. Okay.
Oh. So those three probably won't make it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Haha.
13 times 5. 14 times 5 is...
No, they make it.
Oh, they do?
Yeah, they all do.
Is it a dodge roll he has to do? Dexterity saving throws from the rays?
Well, it depends on...
what the rays are.
On the ray.
But in general, it's just a standard attack on most of them.
All right. Number... We start with number 2, which kind of...
Number 2.
We're going to work our way up.
By the way, number 3
six,
is on the line of... visual range.
Rolling. Give me a second. Rolling perception rolls to see if any of these see any of you, and they do not, so that's fine.
I was like, I rolled a 25, you better not.
I didn't roll
plus 13 to my stealth regardless.
You're,
Number 3. Okay. Give me a wisdom saving throw.
This is not good.
Okay.
That's gonna be bad.
You are frightened for 1 minute.
Oh, that's not bad.
Second ray is I need a constitution saving throw. You're good at those.
You're good at those. Except for that time.
12?
6?
10. 10. Saving throw.
Oh!
You need to roll a 10 though.
10. Right. This other ray shoots out, and it's going to hit you for wow.
Max.
Really? No.
Minimum.
Almost minimum.
Minimum damage.
That is going to be 6 necrotic damage.
Nice. You can't get that back.
All right.
Just take rest. 6 damage. Yeah, for a long
rest.
Well,
no. You can heal it.
Oh.
There's only specific types of necrotic damage that you can't heal.
Oh.
Number 3 is there.
Needs to move. If they're going to do anything. Can you draw a line for you?
Yeah, I can use that, but that'll be alright. I got it. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's a big pile of If it moved That's one, fair. It'd be okay.
That's fair.
That'll teach it.
No, you're right, you're right.
One!
Wisdom saving throw.
Slightly better that time, 15.
15, success! That was the confusion ray.
Oh, that's good.
God, the worst attack in Pokemon.
Yeah.
And
you can launch it, and they'll be confused for one turn. They launch it, you're confused for the rest of the game.
Another constitution save?
Con save.
Oh, that's good. It's,
19 plus
though.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's okay. Which is a little bit better that time, but it's fine. 8 necrotic. Number 4.
Number 2.
Okay, give me another con save.
Huh.
Okay.
Natural 20.
Yeah.
Natural 20.
You're good on that one. And then the next ray is you're already frightened, so that is relevant. Oh, fear? Being frightened. That's a great question. When you are frightened, you have disadvantage on ability checks and attack rolls while the source of your fear is within line of sight, which it is, of course. And, let's see. You cannot willingly move closer to the source of the...
Which one done it?
Damn it. Which one? It doesn't work. You're immune to fear while you're raging.
Yeah.
Oh!
Ha ha! Charm. So don't worry about that part. You're good.
He's like, you're trying to scare me? I'm hurt!
Con save!
Robots.
18. Okay, 6 points of necrotic damage. Number 2 is... another con save.
19.
Okay, you're just... you're killing it.
It can easily reach
I'm counting for my own sake. I can't reach
six.
All four.
Okay.
So you can get those three.
I can get the fuck out of those
give
three.
Give me another 2 con saves.
10 and 25.
Okay, so you're taking 23 necrotic damage, and the 25 will successfully stop the paralysis. Which is always good. Now, that is the end of the surprise round.
I did
and
more damage than all of them.
We are at, I guess that would be back to the top.
Back to initiative.
Yep.
Back to
perk. I'm sure you're mad about this.
I'm a little. It's a little worked. It worked with other actions.
So which one frightened him?
It's an R-Tek.
Number 2.
Oh, then he's fine.
They didn't. They didn't frighten me.
They didn't?
Because he's raged.
Yeah.
You can't.
He's immune to fear while
enraged. Good.
Enraged. Good, good.
And now we have an R-Tek.
An R-Tek.
Wouldn't you... were telling me my necrotic damage, was that already halved?
Yes. It was already halved, yes. It was all already halved, yeah.
Alright.
It's good you cast spot.
Yeah, yeah.
Alright. What you got? What you got hurt?
Sidestep to the left a little bit.
So you want to go here? Like right here.
To the right now. I didn't look up what that is, but just going to attack the shit out of that one now.
Okay.
Regular attacks. Plus the extra attack. So I think I can do that every time. So,
you have, is it barbarian?
He has extra attack.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you can attack twice.
If he's dual wielding, it means he can attack 3 times, alright?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look that up real quick. Just to verify it. And then. Yeah, you just have the extra attack, so yeah, you'll just get the 3 total.
Alright.
Mm-hmm.
That'll work.
Because of the offhand weapon. This. Do you have any feats, or are you just stat boosts?
I think it was just stat boost. Are my totems my feats?
No.
No. Feats are like extras. Like I'm alert. That's a feat.
Okay. No, I do not.
Or I'm also a magic initiate.
Okay. far as I know, I do not have the feats. Just to.
No, we just went straight stats for you, which is appropriate.
We are supposed to take out the beholder, not you.
It's cool.
You break it, we're not gonna fight.
I'm just kidding.
I turn and leave.
So.
Fuck this. I have enough money to retire.
I did.
Yes.
23 and 17, are those both hits? Well, first two swings.
23 and 17 are indeed both hits, yes.
And how about 25? I assume that's also good.
Yeah. Your target. Your target is 14. I'll tell you that. Because it's.
We were going to do it anyway.
You're going to figure it out anyway, so might as well just say
it. Mm-hmm.
D8s and D6s.
Most of you have to roll very low to miss.
I got to roll a 5 or lower to miss.
3d8s, 3d...
And...
We're to add 15 to that roll total.
27 plus 15.
43.
What, 42?
42. Fuck. That guy's okay. Dead too.
Is he?
Actually, that's number. Yeah, he's dead.
42.
Yeah.
I'm gonna change this guy.
Fuck your eyelids.
Because I've fucked up in my notes.
Balls.
And that'll be fine. Okay. Kyren. You are still?
42, huh?
Mm-hmm. So, Snelf gives me.
Advantage on attack rolls.
Mm-hmm. Advantage on attack rolls.
Which therefore means sneak attack.
Yeah, I can
sneak attack.
Mm hmm.
I will take a shot at number 3.
Number
3.
Okay.
You can go away for a while.
That was a 1?
That was a 1. I gotta have a
advantage.
Advantage. 14 plus 8. So yeah.
You got it.
So sneak attack.
6d6. And
66.
Your bow is a D8.
My bow is a D10.
D10.
I have a dragon bow. Dragon bone bow.
That's right. It's a D10. You're right.
Plus ice.
Mm-hmm.
And that's.
Grab your D10 in there.
I got
it. Alright.
In my hand.
And.
Actually, I'll do that one because I'll do the actual numbered one, not the percentile ones.
Because they're annoying when you try to
roll. Yeah.
Yeah, because you're like 80!
Because you're like. Fuck.
83!
Take away the 0, cool as it would be.
Woo!
Yeah.
That's a lot of dice.
Yeah, that happened.
Sorry for my actual damage die. I rolled a 1.
Oh.
We got 10, 16, 20.
You hit number 5?
No, I hit number 3.
I'm a 3.
Got it. See, we got 10, 16, 20, 24, 25, 26. 32 damage altogether.
Very nice.
I'll try to roll higher on the actual damage die.
Yeah.
Is not going to be enough.
Didn't think so.
It's close.
I don't kill minions, I kill bosses.
Sorin. That's fair. After Sorin hurts.
Exactly.
Which one did you hit?
3.
3. So, Thunder's Mark.
Bingo. Cast Thunder's Mark.
It's your bonus action, and then you're gonna.
You could probably kill any of them in one hit.
So I have advantage, correct?
Correct. Only on your first shot.
Which is fine. First shot at number 30.
Would I be able to attempt to go back into stealth?
As a
bonus action?
Yeah, I didn't take one that turn.
To hide, yeah. You're kind of in line of sight, which is tricky.
Actually,
so
you could dive behind me.
Kinda not.
For those.
For those, yeah. The third one's about to die.
That's true. So go ahead and roll it, and we'll take it into account.
15.
Okay.
I rolled 2 5s, but it's still hit.
Did you get
plus 11?
Like
plus 13. Plus
13? Jesus.
My base damage is 11.
So if you rolled a 1, if you rolled a 1, you would have still
number
hit him
three?
Technically.
Yeah.
And number 3. Well, I just did like
32. Alright, I'm going to shift Hunter's Mark to number 4 then.
Okay.
And, only have advantage on...
We'll finish up this fight, and then we'll stop the video.
I only have advantage on the first shot, right?
Yeah.
So I do not have advantage anymore?
Correct.
You went out. And you're out of sneak attack, too.
Now, no. Well, yeah, you only get that once per round anyway.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Never mind.
So I'm gonna
that would be
ahead.
So broken.
I know, right?
It's a number four, correct?
Yeah, you pushed it at number four.
Alright.
Yeah. It's probably also
you see my number four.
Let's use,
I like you're killing them in order.
Marksman!
Good
gonna
deal.
Get that headshot in the eyeball.
He's probably dead.
Roll them our damages.
Alright.
What did you roll?
19
plus stuff.
Plus
the
minus
five.
So. Yeah, that's
definitely.
Plus 13. But you're not a fighter,
five.
So that's not a crit.
That's a very specific fighter event. Although in theory you can do keen up.
If you're a fighter and you don't have that, I feel like you're doing something wrong. But.
Well, that's a specific type of fighter that gets it. It's not like a...
Yeah. Like I said, if you're a fighter and you don't have that...
Unless you're a gunslinger.
You're doing something wrong.
27.
Cool. Nice shot. He's not dead yet. But you hit him.
That was plus the...
Leas.
Can I roll still too?
Is it a bonus action for you?
Wait, is there any darkness in this room?
This room is entirely dark.
Yeah, we're in the underdark.
Yeah, under.
Then I can.
You can hide in shadows, yeah.
And 11 and 13.
That's 24. Battery low. Excellent. Leas, what you got?
Something magical. I'll use...
That's fair.
Something?
I'm gonna use something magical.
Yeah. I think I'm just gonna do a good old firebolt.
Which one?
I have 2d10 written. I think I get 3d10 now at level 11. I want to double check that.
Firebolt?
Firebolt. That's fireball. Firebolt.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Level
at
11 spell change.
11. Yeah, it's 3d10 now. So, firebolt. I'm blasting number 4.
Okay. You are stepping out to do that.
Then I'll stay there and do number... Yeah, no, I'll step out and do number 4. Yeah, just one to the... Whoa, like, one over, I can see him.
Cool. That's fair. Yep. Do it.
Roll to 1.
My favorite. Serendipity?
Wait, you're stealth, aren't you?
I was.
You get advantage.
I get advantage?
Yeah, you're
nice.
Still stealth. It's not like they saw us with their
12
eyes.
Plus 9.
There you go.
Is
okay.
More than 14.
Good save.
Yeah, thanks, bro. So, 3d10.
I was like, knowing my luck, he's going to cast Fireball and he's going to go backwards.
And he'll go fucking backwards.
I don't have time.
I don't know how the fuck that would happen.
You guys roll screwing up, so.
7, 5, and 10. So 15 plus 22. 7 is 22, yeah.
22, number 4 is dead.
Fire.
Yeah. Moving hunter's mark.
Number 5.
Sure, why not?
It's their turn. Leas.
My face. Hey, I can move back, by the way.
Cool.
Behind the other people.
For stealth.
Yeah.
I can't
cover.
Stealth as a bonus action, so can
you
I?
Can't use this as cover.
I'm not using it as cover, I'm moving back down the hallway along the edge. I don't know how much more feet of 20 at least more feet of movement, but regardless, I'm not hiding behind them,
no,
I'm going to the wall.
Problem is, I don't know if I'm
5,
stealth.
10, 15, 20.
You never actually said if I was fully stealth.
It's true, I didn't.
I just shot an arrow. He shot a fireball.
Firebolt.
Same death.
We have dark vision.
Stealth.
Big deal. You are actually seeing because their passive perception is higher than 15.
Damn.
Jesus.
And I'm not. I can't even. I'm not even allowed to hide as a bonus action, right?
No.
That's what I thought.
Leas.
Because I'm not roguey.
I need you to make a Constitution saving throw, please.
Great. Oh, I'm actually good at
those.
I'm pretty good at those. I rolled a 1. It's 8.
Okay, you are paralyzed for 1 minute.
Jesus,
you can
I'm
repeat
out.
The saving throw at the
each round.
Ending the effect on itself as a success. The other shot, I need you to make a con save again.
Me?
Yes.
15 plus 7 is 22.
Very good.
22.
A con?
I have a plus. I am good at con and charisma as a sorcerer.
Neat.
Yep.
So you'll take 6 necrotic damage.
Not too bad.
Chiron. Con save. And con save.
2 con saves.
Mm-hmm.
Which I'm actually good at now.
Right.
I bought a thing.
Right.
Yeah, so you get plus 1.
Plus 5 on top. Plus 1 on top of that extra constitution I have now. So I have a plus 5 to my constitution.
Plus 5
to
my constitution.
Indeed.
13 and 14.
13 and 14
mm-hmm.
are going to be enough. Actually.
So, what I do? What did they try to do?
One was paralyzing ray, and the other one was a fear ray. That's the only two that are left. Alright.
Cool.
This should be mopped up soon. Herc, and then we'll end this part. We're probably about 5 minutes over the senior limit.
And the last one was 5 minutes short.
That's.
So it's okay.
That's fair.
Balances out. Kind of.
You know, which bad stuff, Herc? What you got?
Squish number 5.
Yeah. Speed this 8.
5 and 6 are uninjured as of now.
Thanks, Squish.
The 5's not up word.
5 is probably going to die. What?
What do you need?
Huh?
Uninjured as of the word. You didn't. Anyway, I'm these. Goes. Fucking triple attack. Riggs. 20, 22, and 22.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Jesus.
Dude, if you roll anything higher than a 4, you're hitting them.
Yeah, that's 8. I like it.
Well, if you roll a 4 or higher. So
yeah,
3 or lower is when you miss.
I'll leave the white one.
So these are like little minion-y yos.
Mm-hmm.
43.
It's dead.
It is dead indeed.
Yeah.
You just smashed the shit out of it.
Yeah.
You basically walked in here and went, I'm like you, and I'm like you, and I'm like you.
It's like the Gators at Putt Putt.
Yeah.
Oh!
What's that? You ever play the Gators at Putt Putt?
No.
You get the little man.
Yeah,
yeah.
Whack them all.
It is essentially like a ball.
Alright.
Chiron.
Alright, so I'm not in stealth.
You are not in stealth.
And nobody is near him, so I don't get sneak attack.
Also true, unless Herc wants to finish his movement and go over there.
Would you be a darling?
Yeah, I'll go ahead and flank the shit on him. Around the rear. Well,
okay. Doesn't matter, you're not going to be flanking.
True, I just need to be able to hit it.
That's from his backboard.
Okay, so.
The alley-oop, if you will miss.
Take a shot at number 6 there.
Mm-hmm.
12 plus stuff. Get all my dices here. The red ones. Yeah, the red ones are. It's going to be my nice damage. I keep rolling low on the actual damage dice. That's 10, 20. 29 plus 6 is 35.
35 is not enough.
I understand.
Oh. I understand.
It should be almost be assumed at this point.
Soren, roll to see if you hit.
That's pretty much it.
Darkness down here?
Yes. The only thing that's really lit at the moment is going to be
these bitches' assholes.
The morning star, or the flail rather, that.
But we're essentially in complete darkness?
Essentially, yes. The flails. The fiery flail.
It can't see me anyway. So what I'm going to do is 6 as a move action.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm going to use Shadow Step as a bonus action and teleport behind it.
Okay.
I want to use my Onyx dagger, or my Ebony dagger. Finish it.
Sounds good.
And you're flanking.
And I'm flanking, which means...
Advantage.
Advantage.
Do it.
Both are hits.
Yep. Rolling dar damages.
What was the damage on that dagger?
Dagger is... You don't really know what it does, I don't think. Did you write down what it does?
No, we didn't actually decide.
Didn't decide what it does yet. That's fair.
And I still get the 2d6.
Dagger damage is not a lot.
It's a d4 plus 4 for me.
Yeah. Let's go ahead and roll the d4 plus 4.
And my sneak attack as well.
And your sneak attack. And
four,
do you have
13.
A Colossus Slayer?
Yes,
no, six isn't damaged yet.
Yes, I do.
Yes, it is.
Yes,
damaged.
It is. I damaged
you
it.
You damaged it, right.
And I have Colossus Slayer.
So did you add your d8?
8 more.
So what's that total?
12 and 9. Wait. Number of d6. Plus 6 more. And... Mm-hmm. Yeah, just plus 6, sorry. So, 12 and 3 is 15, plus another 12 in the 20-ish range.
Okay. Very nice, very nice.
Plus 4.
So you move up, you teleport behind it. Herc, you see, because it's facing you. You see its central eye grow wide, and it makes this kind of faint, this weird gurgling noise. And you see its entrails fall out the back of it.
Yeah.
And then standing in front of you is Soren.
All of a sudden.
Hey. Dreading.
Okay. So we killed all of them, right?
Yep. We done.
Can I harvest their eyes?
Yeah. Their, the tentacles?
No, I mean the eyes.
All of
yeah.
it.
I want them.
And some teeth.
I don't think you
okay.
can harvest the ones he ate.
Yeah, so you can harvest.
No, he smashed shit out of
unless
those.
You are looking for
a pulp jelly thing.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. The little container that the guy gave me, would that fit the big eye and then the little ones?
You notice when you activate it, turn it on.
Mm-hmm.
One, it gives off about 5 or 10 feet of light. It glows a little bit.
That's right.
And it's an extra dimensional space, so yes,
it will be able to hold. Then I take the eyes, and I think we should take some of those tentacles. Not all of them, obviously. But I take as many eyes that are in good condition, and...
Okay.
And we take a few of the tentacles.
That's going to take a little bit of time, because you got to cut them out, and...
It is what it is.
I can help him do that.
Do you have the telekinesis spell?
I do.
Okay.
I do now, because I just leveled up.
So, I don't know how that will help.
It wouldn't really too much, because Mage Hand can only lift, like 10 pounds. Telekinesis can lift 1,000, so it would be a lot easier.
It's a big deal for me to use that telekinesis spell, but...
How long does it last? Like an hour?
Yeah.
Anyway, we are out of time, like way out of time for this video. We're going to end it here, and in the next video we'll be facing off against the
Beholder.
Which is super exciting.
Which was 3D.
You gotta have like the suit and everything with the smoker.
That's right.
That's what Beholder is, right?
The beekeeper.
As always, we love all of you guys. This has been the Inquiries of the Illustrious Idiots. We'll have more shows hopefully planned and set up going forward soon. And as always, like, comment, and subscribe, etc. Because, you know, YouTube stuff. Thank you to Syrinscape for being awesome. And we